Let's take you through a recommended workflow for subdivision modeling with the 3D Sculptor role on the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. To get started, we'll use an image to help guide our design. Within the xShape app, we go to the Tools tab and select Insert Picture to begin. We'll select a plane to insert our picture on, and then choose Picture to browse for it. Once the image has been inserted, you can move and scale it before confirming using the handles or advanced scaling options. In this case, we're only focused on shaping and not necessarily the scale, so we'll leave the image size as it is. So with our image in place, we can add a primitive to begin subdivision modeling. Click on the Subdivision tab and then choose a 3D primitive. In this case, we'll choose a box, but to select other primitives, you can click the arrow in the bottom right corner of the icon to view the whole list. Pick whichever primitive matches your shape the best. You can click the box button and then press the Enter key without moving your cursor to place the primitive on the origin. And after placing, you can adjust the scaling if required before clicking the green tick. We're happy with ours, so we'll leave it as default this time. Once placed, all the control points of the primitive are automatically selected, and this will be helpful for the next steps. But if you happen to have clicked into a blank space and already deselected the entities, you can just press the Ctrl and A keys to select all the vertices again. It's always a good idea to rotate your view normal to the model when subdivision modeling, so you're looking directly at the area you're shaping. We rotate normal to our image to begin working. We now start to position the primitive by using the robot. Whenever any entity is selected in xShape, the robot will appear. This includes faces, edges, and vertices. The robot also has 5 types of handles: axial, plane, arc, scale, and center. For more information on using the xShape robot, make sure you check out our introduction to the 3D Sculptor role over on our blog. We'll start with just the X and Y scale handles to stretch and pull the basic box shape into a shape which better fits our controller image. We'll use the axial arrow handles to move all the entities in the X and Y directions until the shape is positioned nicely within our image. Since the controller casing will be symmetrical, we access the symmetry command from the subdivision tab and then select the central plane. This allows any modifications to one side of the symmetry plane to be copied to the other. To align the leftmost edge of our box with the image, we box select the entities that we want to modify, and then use the arc robot handle to match the slope of the controller. Each connected string of edges around a model is known as an edge loop. They can be added or deleted to increase or reduce the number of subdivision control points. In many cases, it's best to start with a reduced number of edge loops to reduce the complexity of the model you're working with, and then add additional loops and control points where detail is required. To simplify the side profile of our controller, we'll delete 2 of the edge loops, which were automatically inserted when the box primitive was added. To select an edge loop, we double-click on a single edge. Then we can delete the loop using the delete key. We'll repeat this for both side profile edge loops. We now need to create some geometry for the controller handholds and trigger casings. To do this, we'll use the extrude command to add material to our primitive. The extrude button in the subdivision task can be clicked for this, or the shortcut for the command can be selected after clicking on a face. We select one of the lower faces where we need material for the handle, then click the extrude button from the pop-up toolbar. 4 new faces will be added between the selected face and existing model to add material to the shape. Since we removed additional edge loops in the previous step, we only need to select one face here. We can then repeat this step to add material for the trigger casing on top. After adding the extrusions, we need to manipulate the new control points created to position them relative to our image. For the lower handles, we'll box select the newly created entities and use the plane robot handle to drag the points within the visible plane. To scale points in 2 directions simultaneously, hold down the Shift key and select both scale circles before dragging. We can then make some similar adjustments to the top of the controller until the subdivision surface roughly matches our image. Another modification we want to make is to sharpen the edges at the top of the controller. This can be achieved with the Crease command. We'll select one trigger face and then shift select the other to select all the faces in between. Now, depending on the placement of your cursor within the second face selection, the opposing loop of faces may be selected. Once pre-selected, select the crease button from within the subdivision tab. Using the slider which appears will give us more control to decide how sharp the edges need to be. Until now, we've only been modifying our subdivision in one dimension. However, we are required to make the controller handles curve downwards and to reduce the overall thickness of the controller. This can be achieved by rotating our view to look side on at the subdivision and then manipulating again using the robot. By box selecting the lower half of the entities and then using an axial handle, we can reduce the thickness of the model. To provide curvature to the handles, we can box select some entities and use arc and planar handles to position them appropriately. So that's the bulk of the subdivision modeling done. From here, we could fit internal components by inserting parts or assemblies into the X-shape environment to fine-tune the casing design. Then we'd export our result and take it into SOLIDWORKS or 3D Creator to add parametric control. For more subdivision and 3D modeling tips and tutorials, be sure to check out our other videos or visit our website to learn more.